Welcome back to Weekly Briefing. We are here with our panel of experts. Joining me in studio, Malik Abdul, GOP political strategist. Jim Hansen, president of Security Studies and author of Winning the Second Civil War Without Firing a Shot. Donna Jackson, accountant and member of Project 21. And One America News' bureau chief, John Hines. President Trump announced this week that he is initiating a class action lawsuit to protect First Amendment rights. Here's the big announcement.
I just want to say that I stand before you this morning to announce a very important and very beautiful, I think, development for our freedom and our freedom of speech, and that goes to all Americans. Today, in conjunction with the America First Policy Institute, I'm filing, as the lead class representative, a major class action lawsuit against the big tech giants, including Facebook, Google, and Twitter, as well as their CEOs, Mark Zuckerberg, Sundar Pichai, and Jack Dorsey. Three real nice guys.
John, what do you make of Donald Trump suing big tech?
Well, that was a great clip, but I thought the most important thing he said in that entire press conference is, he said words to the effect is, it's not about me, it's about you. I'm here, they're not just coming after me, they're coming after you. And this is the point, really, is that there are so many people, particularly conservatives, who have experienced censorship, mm-hmm. who have been shadow banned, and they really have no recourse because they're basically Joe Sixpack or Mary Jane Sixpack. And the president has a heck of a bullhorn. He has a voice. He has the fame. He has the financial resources to stand up and be counted and make a point, yeah. which is exactly what he wants to do. It not only serves this issue, to further this issue into the public discourse, it also, not incidentally and not coincidentally, positions him very well in 2022 and 2024.
Right.
And with this announcement, I would say it looks very much like he's positioning himself to run in 2024.
I think you might be right. What do you make of the lawsuit, Jim?
Well, I'm happy he's doing it. I wish he'd have done it while he was still president and he had some executive authority. But I mean, personally, I'm one of the conservatives who's been this. I lost my blue check mark for just changing my username, and I just got it back. Woohoo!
What was your username? Well, what did you do, Jim?
I used to be Uncle Jimbo and became Jim Hansen DC because I'm an important think tank guy. But now they still have a sensitive filter on my account. So if you don't follow me and you go to my Twitter account, you see a grayed out thing that says this user posts sensitive content. And I mean, sensitive, yeah, if you're a snowflake and I make you cry because you're a leftist, but not sensitive in the usual terms. It's just because leftists complain and
right.
they have a social media credit score. I hope Trump can deal with that in
right.
some way with this lawsuit.
Right. Donna, what do you make of this lawsuit?
Well, I'm glad that he's doing it, and I'm interested to see how the Supreme Court is going to weigh in, because Justice Clarence Thomas, he yeah. made a remark in the fact that he thought that one day they would have to have a suit like that. And, you know, these companies, they operate differently than other private companies. Normally, I would say private companies can do what they want, but they operate differently. And so I think that this has to go
right.
to that level so that people can have free speech.
And Pam Bondi actually addressed that in the announcement earlier this week. She mentioned that Facebook and Twitter, they're working with the federal government. They're
right.
working in coordination. They were sharing trade secrets. A lot of the information that was released for this lawsuit was redacted,
right.
and it was redacted because it's privileged for the government. So I thought she laid out the case quite compelling, that they actually are government actors and should be held to the same standards as the government.
Yes.
A group of Russian-based hackers claimed responsibility for a cyber attack on over 200 businesses. The group is demanding $70 million as ransom to return the information that they stole. This is the second time U.S. critical infrastructure has been held ransom under the Biden administration, the first one being the Colonial Pipeline. This week, President Biden addressed the attack when asked by reporters if the administration was going to respond.
I can tell you a couple things. I received an update from a national security team this morning. It appears to have caused minimal damage to U.S. businesses, but we're still gathering information to the full extent of the attack, and I'm going to have more to say about this in the next several days. We're getting more detail and information, but that's what I can tell you now. and I feel good about our ability to deal with this. Thank you.
I feel good about our ability to, I have no idea. What do you think, Jim?
I think he feels good about his ability to order ice cream and get positive coverage from the media. Reading off another flashcard, Joe pointed out the problem. Nobody takes him seriously.
Right.
Putin, most assuredly, and anybody who's doing any of the hacking from the Eastern European side, as opposed to the Chinese side, who are also hacking us relentlessly. But from the Eastern European side, Putin knows about it, he approves it, and he knows he can get away with it. And until the United States can show enough backbone or a leader who's at least competent enough to deal with this, it's going to continue to happen. And we really have no recourse. I don't believe he can take care of it.
Well, at the time that that comment was made by Joe Biden, that was 4 days after the attack had occurred. And he was still looking for information, and he still wasn't sure, you know, what he felt good about. What do you think, Malik?
Yeah, so the irony here is that, you know, a couple of weeks back, there was this whole big discussion about Joe Biden. You know, the United States is back. Joe Biden, you know, he's entering the world stage. And this notion was, which happens with every U.S. president, that he's going to go in and give it to Putin. Well, he didn't. And one of the things that he said is that I told him is that if this happens again, then we're going to have a serious discussion and the United States will respond. I'll be interested to see what Biden does in response, but I doubt it would be anything far beyond what the U.S. government always does. Everybody wants to, you know, give it to Putin, but it literally never happens. And so for all of the bravado that Biden had about he's going to take it to Putin, that's not going to happen.
That's a great point. Is that not more likely than not that this was Russia's response to Joe Biden posturing? He's posturing saying, oh, I gave it to Putin. And with days, many of our infrastructure was held for ransom for $70 million. And Joe Biden's bumbling off of a stage going, oh, I gave it to him.
16?
Sure did.
Yeah, that's true. He did.
You have had it.
Oh, my word.
Nobody thought he was going to be.
But don't worry, folks. The United States is back.
Right.
Joe Biden also gave a speech this week to tell Americans that his administration is, I quote, literally knocking on doors to get people vaccinated. He also somehow linked that to equality. Follow this next clip if you can.
Literally knocking on doors to get help to the remaining people protected from the virus. Look, equity, equality, it remains at the heart of our responsibility of ensuring the communities.
That honestly was the most coherent 30 seconds that I could get out of that speech. Malik, what do you think about that?
So the Biden administration has done, and they started it during the campaign, so no longer are they actually talking about addressing issues that are germane to the Black community or Hispanic community. The word here is equity. Now, equity. What is the equity in vaccine distribution? I live here in Washington, D.C., and our vaccines were made available, I think, probably the second week in January. This is before Biden even took office. If you look at where the numbers are, many of these areas where, you know, largely Democrat areas, there is no problem with equity with vaccine distribution. So this is just kind of one of these throw-out terms.
It's a messaging thing.
That's literally all it is. But I can tell you, I've actually been vaccinated. But Biden and his people, they better not show up at my door.
Is that why your hair grew back? It's the vaccine.
Somebody give him a constitution. I mean, he's really going to go door to door telling people they have to get vaccinated.
Right.
And then what about all the illegal immigrants that are allowed to come in the country unvaccinated that he doesn't have a problem with, that he's actually giving cash away and telling them to come to flood cities so that he could try to turn them blue. So they don't need a vaccine. He doesn't need to go door to door for them, but he needs to go door to door to a regular Americans. Why? To try to intimidate them, to say the federal government is going to micromanage your life, and if you don't fall in line, then we'll get you. And it's all fear. That's all it is.
That's a good point. The lower class doesn't need them knocking on their doors. Jim, what do you think about them going door to door?
My wife had a guy works for, lives in D.C. The bums in the park across from his apartment got vaccinated before he did. So they were higher. You want to talk about equity, all right? That's equity right there.
Or scary.
Anybody who wanted a vaccine could get one, all right? I got one. Because I want to be able to tell people, don't tell me to wear a mask and don't knock on my door.
Right.
No.
Yeah.
People have the right to not be vaccinated. That's
course,
the bottom line.
Of course.
So you can't force people to do something they don't want to.
That's right. Don't go anywhere. When we come back from the break, we'll discuss the Black National Anthem at the 4th of July. We'll be right back.